everyone! I am Rebecca from ChemKnits. Tomorrow is Thanksgiving, which means that there are a ton of sales and discounts this week. And that includes the ChemKnits Creations Etsy shop. My shop is filled with hundreds of skeins of hand-dyed yarn that are featured in videos here on the ChemKnits Tutorials YouTube channel. Every skein of yarn in my shop is labeled with the title and date the video it was featured in came out, so that way you can easily find the video and watch exactly how I created that colorway. And for Black Friday, I am having a sale. Select skeins of ready-to-ship yarn are 20 to 60% off, and there's some other special deals and listings that I will get to at the end of the video. But first, let's dye some falling leaves yarn. I dyed the Thanksgiving fallen leaves colorway on Knit Picks Stroll Fingering Weight yarn, which is 75% superwash merino, 25% nylon. But I also dyed a batch off camera on Knit Picks Swish DK yarn, which is 100% superwash merino. I started with 500 grams of yarn in the pan, which is a lot for me. The pan started with 8 cups of water and 3 tablespoons of white vinegar. And then I put on my respirator mask, safety glasses, and gloves, and started heavily layering on Paradise Fibers Red Acid Dye. Once I layered on that dye, I used a spoon to spread it out and then layered on brown in sort of heavy speckles, but I did not move it through this time. After letting it set for about 5 to 10 minutes, I opened up the yarn and retwisted it, twisting tight again to fit all of the yarn in the pan. And then this time I used Paradise Fibers Orange to heavily go all over the surface of the yarn. Then using hands or spoons to move that dye through a little bit, which not only helped that color dissolve, but did move it through a few more layers of yarn before speckling with some brown. After another 5 to 10 minutes, I opened up and retwisted the yarn again, and then I poured over some brown dye that I had dissolved in water. I took a quarter teaspoon, a heaping teaspoon, of the brown acid dye and dissolved it in 8 cups of hot tap water with 3 tablespoons of white vinegar. And then I poured this all over the yarn so that way we could layer this color on. And I know it looks like a lot, but really it's gonna mute some of the brightness of the red and orange and be really, really beautiful. And here is that first batch of yarn. When I opened the skeins at the end, after 10 minutes or so, and let it sort of sit in solution, that let some of the browns spread a tiny bit more, which really softened the pastel regions, the white, to make it more tan. And I really, really like it. This colorway has bright colors, but also softer orange and red with some light-ish. I mean, there was a lot of brown speckling added on, but ultimately you don't feel a lot of the speckles because the yarn was twisted when I added it on. And so I think that this is just a very fun Thanksgiving variegated colorway. There is only one part of this dye recipe where I actually measured out the amount of dye I used. So from batch to batch, there's some variation in the amount of red and orange in the yarn because, I mean, that depended on how much my fingers decided to add in the moment. But overall, while we have some different dye lots potentially, there is a consistency to it, and I'm very happy with the colorway. And I also had an adorable little yarn mop that I used when I was dyeing the yarn, and then just with any leftover brown dye that I had at the very end. And this was on Knit Picks Hawthorn, which is 80% superwash fine highland wool, 20% polyamide. So what am I gonna do with the falling leaves colorway? Well, have a Black Friday deal for all of you. For a limited time, if you purchase a skein of the falling leaves yarn, you can add a skein of mystery yarn for just $10. This is something I really enjoy doing around Black Friday and is a fun twist on a clearance. All these deals that I'm talking about are available through Monday, November 29th at 11:59 p.m. Eastern Time, or while supplies last. So if you're interested, don't wait too long because things could sell out. In addition to the buy the Thanksgiving yarn, get a mystery skein for $10, I am also offering a mystery yarn bundle that comes with this beautiful sunflower project bag and at least 300 grams of yarn in either fingering or DK weight. Check out the listing for more details, but there'll be some other fun extras and things in there as well. And because this mystery yarn bundle is at such an extreme discount already, no coupons can be applied to this particular listing. For this Cyber Week, I have also brought back a few Just One Night Hanukkah mini skeins from the 2019 Hanukkah special. And there are just a few, and those also can come with some lobster claw stitch markers. And you can pick the night that you get. Finally, I want to offer a tiny spoiler warning because there are some fun extras that are featured in the upcoming ChemKnits Hanukkah special that are also now in the shop. And so you can go and check that out in the everything else section to see what is there. But I'm not going to show pictures of that here because if you have not yet opened your Hanukkah sampler box, I do not want to spoil it. So there we have it. I have some new special listings, a lot of brand new colorways that have just been listed, and some mystery bundles. And so I really hope that you will take advantage of some of these offers. I don't do big site-wide sales very often, but I really enjoy doing this around Black Friday because I think that it is just it's just a lot of fun. I want to thank you all so much for watching this video and going and checking out the ChemKnits Creations Etsy shop. Shopping there is really a great way to help support the content here. But ultimately, the biggest way that you can help support ChemKnits is by watching the videos and engaging with them. Every time you subscribe or give a like, that's telling YouTube that you enjoy that content, and so then they recommend it to more people. So that really is the biggest way that you can help support the content here. And I just have to thank you all from the bottom of my heart for joining me on my artistic journey as I play with color and yarn. I know there is so much more I want to explore. My list of things I want to do keeps getting longer and longer and longer, which, I mean, as a YouTuber, is a really good thing. Happy Thanksgiving, everyone. I am Rebecca from ChemKnits, and thank you so much for watching.